The Minister for Teso Affairs, Clement Kenneth Ongalo, launched the parish development model at the Kalaki District Headquarters, where several SACCO leaders were present to witness the occasion. Ongalo asked all those who received money to see that it is used for the intended purpose.
We develop the sign very, very carefully to avoid failure, because PDM, I want to assure you, must succeed, and it will succeed.
At least 10 members from different PDM circles in Kalaki District received money in their respective accounts.
There is a message from Centenary Bank. Dear Mr. Eyoku, a transaction of 1 million on your account XXX on the 10th of May 23 at 14:59. Okay.
Meanwhile, MPs on the Parliamentary Forum on Youth Affairs visited Kalangala on a fact-finding mission on how youth access sexual reproductive health services. Among the challenges discussed were non-friendly health workers, language barrier, lack of transport, and ignorance.
The younger, the problem we face mostly, there is a problem of admin in the facilities where we do get the services. Where you can find, as me right now, I can go to the hospital, find there someone who is at 40. I can't tell that person my problem.
Sulait Chiza, the Kasekulo Health Center 2 in charge, say the facility works on over 3,000 people per month, which puts pressure on drug supply.
We have the coverage catchment area of our Kasekulo Health Center, 3,800. Yeah. We have some challenges with our management of patients, like as NMS, they send into drugs at our facility, yet you have different conditions of categories of people. They can send a cycle of drugs whereby instead of finishing three months, it ends up in 2 weeks.
Most of them don't understand their sexual reproductive health, and so that's why some of them are taking very high risk decisions. Like for example, yesterday we heard of a lady who was deceived by a friend that when you have sex once, that is it, you will not get pregnant, and she ended up being pregnant.
We shall sit as members of parliament on the Parliamentary Forum on Youth Affairs, and we draw our recommendations to the Ministry of Health to see how it will help on these challenging problems.
The situation is very disheartening. The most pertinent of all is the high defilement cases. There is a ratio of 9 to 10 defilement cases out of other cases in Kalangala. And to make matters worse, there is no high court. They are operating on a circuit basis from Masaka. And the circuit operation can barely cover the high report cases, can barely effectively have the law implemented against the perpetrators of the crime.
Report by Michael Onyinge and Samuel Nkuba for the news.